Hello everyone, I am Ritika Zuzgar, Assistant Professor IT Department. So in the course of Machine Learning, we started our Unit 6. Okay. So in that we discuss about what is meant by neural network and what are the two fundamental concepts used in the neural network. So first concept is the artificial neural network and the second concept is the biological neural network. So in previous video, we already discussed about what is meant by artificial neural network and biological neural network. So you can check this ANN and BNN concept in the description box. Okay. So in this video, we discuss about the analogy between the artificial neural network and biological neural network. How our neural network or how our artificial neural network mimic to this biological neural network system. Okay. So in this video, we discuss about the difference between the ANN and BNN, and another concept we discuss what is meant by transformation function in an artificial neural network and the working of this transformation neural network also. Okay, so let us discuss first. The next one is the analogy between BNN and ANN. Okay, in a unit 1, we already discussed the concept of biological neural network and artificial neural network and the analogy between the BNN and ANN. Okay, so the network is the basic units which can solve the many problems. So let us see how we can mimic this biological neuron to our artificial neuron network. So neural network, or it is called as a perceptron. So now here we can see that the figure can considering the two parts. The first part we can see it is basically the figure of a biological neural network, and the second part figure is basically the artificial neural network. So the artificial neural network, that is a perceptron. Here if we can see the input in this figure, the artificial neural network is x1, x2, dot dot up to the xn are the input to the perceptron, and all the input comes to this part is called as summation unit. So it is basically same as the input from the different part. It is coming like x1, x2, x3, x4 and coming to this part, and this is the summation unit. And another important thing that we can note here is that whenever the signal is coming here, it basically comes with some weight. Okay. So the weights are W1, W2, W3 up to the Wn. Okay, like this. So similarly, it is also the signal that is coming here with the certain weights. So weights is basically indicates that how the signal is significant to these neurons. So all the signals, those are coming, they are called as a weighted signals. So now when the weighted signals comes into the summation unit, basically all the signals and multiplied by their weights are summed up, and then the total summation of this train will be passed through this. So this is just like an axon. Okay, the summation units works like an axon, and this is just like axon, and then the comes to this point, and this point is basically now the signals which are summed up here comes to the point same as the synapses or junction. It basically connects connection to other neuron. Now the signals which are arrived here, whether the signal strength is greater than the threshold value or not. If the signal strength is greater than the threshold value, then the signal will pass to the further. But if it is less than, then it will not pass. So this way we can say this part is same as the part, same as this part, and this part is this one. Okay. So this is the biological neuron, and this is the artificial neuron. And we can see that how this biological neuron works, it can be considered to work here and basically writing. For the program, that means computation is concerned, it has to computation. So input is there and output is there. As you know, every computation in computation, the input and output is there, and this is the system which basically map given an input to an output. Given an input to an output and the mapping. So there are two mapping functions or simple functions that will calculate is called as the summation of products of all the weights. Summation of products of all the weights and their inputs. That is the summation unit of xi wi plus x, x1 w1 plus x2 w2 plus x3 w3 up to the xn wn. This is the basically computation that can take place here in this part of simple program with the simple loop. And then here the another program we can think about, whenever it receives this input, that means these are the sum of all the inputs, it is there, it will check with respect to the sum threshold value. If the input the sum is greater than the threshold value, then it will pass. Okay, that time the output is a 1. So it is basically what if then command is there, a very simple code. Okay, so I can understand is that the way this biological neuron works. So we can write a simple program to mimic the working of the biological neurons by means of a perceptron. The artificial neural network is concerned, and as I told you that this work has sudden the computation per thing. So the input weights are the input. If the input weights are the input and the weight are the input and weight are the input to the things, and this is done module or a one function. So the another function is output. Okay, the one function is the output and one function is the input and weight, and the another function is the output. So this way this neurons system will work. And now let us see how this neuron network is basically solve many problems. Okay, so now there exactly I just want to repeat the same things but in a different way. If this this is the input, and the input to the system, then the reproduces the output by means of this program, produces the output. So I is there and I passing some some input signal to the I is the input signal, passing the summation in unit to the threshold unit. Okay, so I means the collection of all the inputs. So the function I passing from summation unit to the threshold unit. So this function we call the transferring function or the transfer function. So this transfer function is denoted in a pi. Okay, the transfer function, so denoted by the phi. And for this function, I is the input and y is the output. I is the input and y is the output. So this is the transfer function, right? So this function, this transfer function takes this I as an input and then produces the output y. So now again, this actually we can write y is a function. So So this actually we can write to y is a function of I, or it is a phi of I like. So as you know, we have mentioned at the very beginning of this soft computing course in system, there is a antecedent and the consequences. Okay, so it is the antecedent. Okay, this is the antecedent, and the conjugated is basically maps into input to the output. So the mapping this way. So we can understand that this neuron or is a perceptron rather how map an input to an output using the transfer function phi. So this phi returns 1, or this phi returns either 1 and 0, and this is the rule that it follows. So if the I is greater than theta, here we consider some theta value. Theta means what? Our threshold unit. Okay. So as I said, in the transfer function, we are creating one threshold unit value and we get the output. Okay. So in the if the value of I, that is input value, is greater than theta, then the function of phi return 1. Okay. And if the I value is less than equal to theta, then the output is 0. Clear? If I is greater than theta, जो भी input के value है वो अगर threshold unit से greater है, so we get the output value is 1. Okay? And if the input value is less than or equal to theta, then the output is 0. Y is equal to 0. So this one transfer function that we have discussed, and it follows the rules like this. And if a transfer function follows this kind of simple concept, 1 and 0, then it is called as a step function. Okay, see here. So a very commonly known transfer function is called as a thresholding function. Okay, so this is also called as a threshold function, denoted by phi. And in this thresholding function, that is sum of input I. Thresholding function means what? Our sum of input I. Okay, all the product of input and weight and the summation of all this weight and input we get here denoted by I. So if the value of I is greater than theta, then the output is 1, and it is, otherwise if the I is less than equal to theta, then the value is 0. Okay? So in other words, we can say that, so this is our I. I means what? Our summation of wi xi. So follows the transfer function or thresholding function minus theta. So if we are using here I is greater than theta, then output is 1, and if the I is less than equal to theta, so the output is 0. Okay, so this simple concept of transfer function is also called as a step function, and also alternatively this function is also called as a Heaviside function. Okay, so this concept of this transfer function having some input values where the input is greater than theta, then output is 1. If the I is greater than I is less than equal to theta, then the output is 0. So this simple function is called as a step function, which is also called as a Heaviside function. Clear? Okay, so transfer functions contain the two types. First is a hard limit transfer function, and the second one is a linear transfer function. So we have to learn about the basics of simple transfer function that is there in the theory of artificial neural network. So sometimes this step function is also called as a hard limit transfer function. See here. यहाँ पे जो भी स्टेप फंक्शन का जो भी फॉर्मूला लिखा है वो सिमिलर टू द हार्ड लिमिट ट्रांसफर फंक्शन है. ओके, सो द हार्ड लिमिट ट्रांसफर फंक्शन इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ स्टेप फंक्शन. सो ऑन द अदर हैंड द हार्ड लिमिट ट्रांसफर फंक्शन देर इज अनादर फंक्शन विच इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ लीनियर ट्रांसफर फंक्शन. ओके, सो इन दैट hard limit transfer function, we are having the input and output. So if the input value is, or I value is greater than theta, then the output is like this. Okay. And in the linear transfer function, the output of transfer function is made equal to its input and it lies in the range of minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. So in the linear transfer function, if the I value is greater than theta, then the output is plus 1. If the I is less than equal to theta, then the output value is a minus 1. And the third one is a sigmoid transfer function, where in the sigmoid transfer function we are applying the log values. Okay. So in the sigmoid transfer function, in the case I can see that we can see that if the input within this range, then the function phi returns 0, and if the input is beyond this range, okay, if the input value is in between range, then phi returns 0, and if the input value is beyond this range, then output function returns 1. Okay, so this is a plus 1, this is a minus 1. See here. So it is basically, if the input within the range, it returns minus 1, and beyond the range, it will return only 1. Okay. So there are two functions are there in the addition to these two transfer functions. There are few more transfer functions are very important. Okay, hard limit transfer function, linear transfer function, and sigmoid transfer function. So these transfer functions are called as a sigmoid transfer function. So in that sigmoid transfer function has two versions. One is called as a log sigmoid function, and the another is called as a tan sigmoid function. So the one is called as a log sigmoid function, which basically takes this form, and another is a tan sigmoid function, which is basically take this form, that is formula. So now it apparently seems that these two functions or these two transfer functions very difficult to compute, but there is a computation tricks. If we are applying some computation tricks over here, by which all this calculation of log sigmoid and tan sigmoid can be computed very efficiently. Okay. So compared to this hard limit transfer function and linear transfer function, sigmoid transfer function is difficult to compute. Okay, but if you are applying some calculations accurately for log sigmoid and tan sigmoid, so the computations become work efficiently. Okay, computation becomes easy. Okay, in the sigmoid transfer. Okay, so here we discussed the artificial neural network, where we are having the transformation function in between input and output. So there are different transformation functions are present: hard limit transfer function, linear transfer function, and sigmoid transfer function. The next is the advantages of artificial neural network. So this artificial neural network, why we should follow this artificial neural network to solve our problem. Okay, so this is because it is very nice to mapping the capabilities. Mapping means what? Input and output. Okay, in the neural networking, we are having different number of inputs, and based on the inputs, we can generate the output. So this is process is called as a mapping of input and output. Okay, so why we use the artificial neural network? Because in this artificial neural network, the mapping capabilities, the ANA exhibits the mapping capabilities, that is, they can map the input pattern to their associated output patterns. That means any input it gives to you, so it can map to any type of output, and that is with a very faster rate. Okay. So that is why the any input can be any type of pattern. So then it can read the result and the corresponding output patterns very efficiently or effectively. So and another important thing why we use the artificial neural network. So neural network is concerned whatever the different parameters we have mentioned. So the different parameters means the transfer function. Okay, so that different parameters means alpha in the transformation function, or the number of units or weights in the neurons. So all these are the parameters basically which characterize a behavior of a neurons. So now if we can decide the value of the neuron, okay, so neuron value either 1 or 0, okay. So if we can decide the value of this neuron, then enough the neuron can work for you. So again, the value of this weight or transfer function or threshold values, everything can be learned automatically if you train the neuron, okay. So in the if you are having some input value but we don't know the weight value threshold unit, okay, so how we generate the output, okay. So the so these values, weights and the value of the weight value or value of the threshold unit generated based on the neurons, how we train the neurons, okay. So the value of the weight, transfer function and threshold value, it can be learned automatically if you train the our neuron. So the advantage is the artificial neural network is very much robust, fault tolerance, and therefore it can recall the full pattern of incomplete or partially noisy inputs. Okay, so as I said in my previous video, the soft computing has different characteristics. Okay, robustness. Then the in the soft computing why we use the soft computing. Okay, so if you are having some noisy data, so soft computing provide the result or to remove the unambiguous data or to remove the ambiguity, okay, between this data, okay, and provide the unambiguous or clear meaning of that data, okay. So this is because of the soft computing, okay. So here the artificial neural network ka advantage kya hai. So this artificial neural network is very much robust, fault tolerance, and therefore it can recall the full pattern for incomplete or partially noisy input. So this artificial neural network can be used to process the information in parallel at a very high speed and in the distributed manner. So that's why the neural system is effectively for parallel distributed processing, and we can solve any problems which cannot be solved using the single processing method. Okay, so if you are having some problem, we cannot solve this type of problem by using the single processing method. So in that we use the parallel distributed processing. Okay, so neural system works parallelly. Okay, see here in this diagram, all the inputs and weights are parallel to each other. Okay, if you are using the neural network, so they work parallelly. So this is called as a parallel distributed processing. So this is the advantages of the artificial neural network is having. Okay, so these are the advantages of artificial neural network. The next is the advantages of neural network. Okay, so the main aim of the advantages is that they solve the problems in parallel. Okay, and the artificial neural network use the electrical signal to communicate. So the main disadvantage is that they are not fault tolerant. That is, if any one of the artificial neural network get damaged, it will not function anymore. Okay, so agar hamara output generate hote time jo bhi neurons se wo fail hote hai aur damage hote hai, so we cannot get the proper result or we cannot get the proper transfer function. Okay, and the advantage is that they solve the problem in parallelly. Then artificial neural network use the electrical signal to communicate, and the disadvantage is what? Is that they are not fault tolerant. Okay. So these are the advantages of neural network. So in this lecture, we discuss the artificial neural network working with transfer function. There are three types of transfer function: hard limit transfer function, linear transfer function, sigmoid transfer function. Advantages of artificial neural network and the advantages of neural network. Okay. Thank you.